15 seconds. Oh, man, how is he standing? Brutal knee to the body. Wow! Brother, how about those God minutes? Round two now is upon us. Conor McGregor and Jose Aldo.
He's really using his reach advantage there as he lands the punch, DC.
He blocks the punch. Now his lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Well, most fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this. Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press it. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Oh! Oh, straight right. Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. That one appeared to stun him.
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Yeah, I've hurt him a little bit.
Well, it's one thing to have length. It's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there. Ball.
.105 total strikes have landed for Conor McGregor. And if you care at home, the accuracy rate now, 53% against Jose Aldo.
Wanna give boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod, man a real life sugar gal and my forget what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top, switching lanes the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus, maybe this a Moncler sweater, diesel denim, buy another one, my pockets fat like heather, neck froze like I don't know no better, benzo truck, white seats and they leather, go broke never, on my grind, she make it clap like I'm Busta Rhymes, I got the juice, the sauce and all them things, I glammed her twice a night with all my bling, big Benz I drive, I brought that thing, any girl you want, they want my team.
All right, coming up next, it is a featherweight matchup between Brian T. City Ortega and Charles Oliveira.
You ready? You ready?
All right, so the fight is now underway. We'll see how long it goes. You've got a submission specialist on one side and on the other side. Maybe the most well-rounded fighter.
Yeah, he is one of the best fighters in the entire UFC. But in front of him, he has one of the most dangerous fighters across all divisions in the octagon. Because that one skill he has is so good that you're in danger the entire time.
All right, here we go. First round is underway. No denying the big reach advantage for him tonight. We'll see if he can get that jab going early.
Look for him to serve.
Whoa!
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Oh!
He's in trouble. He's getting lit up.
Combinations here.
All right, stacked guard here, DC. The feet are on the hips. What does that mean?
I mean that he's out. The moment you get the feet on the hips, all he's got to do now is just straight leg. He's got to kick and push. What a beautiful
one. There's the double leg takedown, DC. That is just too good. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom. the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
All right, guys.
Nicely done.
Well, you know, I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in a gi at some point in his life with the way that he moves so freely.
I'm skipping jiu-jitsu next week, too.
Under 2 minutes to go. Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
About the speed on that reversal there. I mean, I know you can get out of some bad spots, but not with that type of speed.
Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom. The Kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
And he's out. Seconds now to go in the round.
All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. Looks like maybe he's trying to get an arm underneath the chin.
He's side to side, trying to get a bulldog choke. Oh, wow, oh!
Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. How about this fight, folks? You see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round. Saved by the bell, so back to the stool. Mentally probably not in a great place here. We'll see if he can recover and get himself back into this fight. Well, he had a lot more than a puncher's chance coming in. Big knockdown for him in the previous round. DC, talk us through the highlight.
He got in his opponent's face, landed that big punch that put his opponent flat on his back. He couldn't get the finish.
Well, round one, a tough act to follow. Now we get to our second round. Brian Ortega and Charles Oliveira.
Nice body.
Oliveira gets caught with that punch. Oh! And a knee.
Oh, nice job to land the straight punch there. Must be nice to have that kind of reach advantage, DC. I know you can't necessarily relate. Man, is he timing his shots well here tonight, DC. It's hard to recall him being this accurate in the past.
I mean, he is so sharp. And not only is he accurate, he's also keeping very busy.
Oliveira gets touched by that kick there. Straight right hand, no good. Hook to the head lands flush there by Oliveira. Big right hook coming, it's blocked.
Very tricky when he throws that body kick. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Double leg is good. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions. Potentially working on a leg attack here, DC.
It looks like he's attacking a heel hook. Oh, nice.
Come on, you gotta get out of there.
Lands a strike now from the bottom. Nice work there by Oliveira. And he's out. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Oh, nice job to reverse position on the ground.
It was bad, but now it's not so bad. What a fantastic sweep.
Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself in the pocket. Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night.
48 total strikes have landed for Brian Ortega. Well, still connecting on about 4 of every 10 attempts. 40% the accuracy right now against Charles Oliveira. Really good job by him there to raise the guard, DC, and block those shots coming his way.
He does a great job.
Oh.
trouble. He's hurt bad.
Tonight against Charles DuBronx Oliveira.
Nice strike.
Big knee lands there. Knee to the body. Oh, big knee.
Dude's hurt. Serve him up.
Oh, he dove and he lands. Wow. Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
He got him back!
Oh, nice job using his strength there. Posture up. We'll see what he can do.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Doesn't gain top position.
What a beautiful takedown, but he just waited for 1 second, and his opponent reacted before he could secure top position.
Nice job. Oh, fight thus far. How's his opponent still standing?
I mean, I have no idea. This fight is supposed to be over. And it might not be over now, but it's gonna be over very soon.
I need you to pay attention.
Oh, he's really starting to apply pressure on his opponent here. Different approach here in the last couple rounds, and it's the exact sense of urgency that you wanna see from a fighter. Take the judges out of it. Oh, a little single collar tie there. Oh, now going to the judo throw, and he ends up in side control. A lot of options for him here.
Yeah, he can go ground and pound.
Top pressure being applied here. Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground. That's very important.
All right, so as we await the judges' scorecards, DC will look back at his handiwork. He had it all going from a striking standpoint tonight.
Man, he did a great job. It was very entertaining to watch someone be in such a great state of flow, a great flow state in regards to the stand-up. He said that tonight, he would be very impressed with his performance, and I am thoroughly impressed.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All three judges score this contest by 9-28. For the winner by unanimous decision, Brian T. City Ortega!
All right, congratulations to him. He is your winner by unanimous decision and certainly a dominant performance here tonight.